Hi guys, this is Saja. This is tutorial is continuous of the previous tutorial or the basics of Blender. Okay, how to move the object, how to constrain the movement of the object. Okay, you can constrain the movement of that object by selecting the specific arrow of that object. Okay, you can constrain the movement of this object of the object by selecting the specified axis arrow. Okay, you can see right now I am doing the constraint. Okay, the upper axis of the Blender is Z. Okay, so please be very careful on that, because some software use upper axis as Y, so please be very careful. And also you can constrain the object movement by using keyboard by just press the G key and tell the specific in what action with what axis you want to constrain the object. Okay, press Z, then the object will be constrained on Z axis. If you press X, the object will be constrained on the X axis. Y, if you press Y, the object will be constrained on the Y axis. Okay, if you want to constrain the rotation of that object, press R, and next you press the specific axis in which you want to rotate. Okay, I'll press Z. Okay, now you can see the object rotation is constrained to Z axis. Okay, you can also use same thing for scaling by pressing S and next press the specified specified axis, so that the object will be scaled on that axis, will be constrained on that axis. Okay, you can also give the keyboard input by pressing G key on the specific axis and tell them the value, how long this have to be, how what is the value to be applied on that property of that object. Okay, I'll show you an example. I want to move this object in the Z axis 5 unit. Okay, to do that I press G key and I will press the Z axis and I will say I want to move this to 5 unit. I press 5 in the keyboard. Now the object is moved 5 unit upward in the Z axis. Okay, how to select the all the object in the Blender? Okay, you can select all the object by pressing A key in the keyboard. Okay, if you press the A key again, it will deselect all the object. Okay, and next I'm going to teach you a very important concept called normals. Okay, normal is very important for all the fill in graphics. Okay, 3D graphics, without normal you cannot do anything. Okay, I'll show you what is normals. Go to add, I'll create a cube. Okay, I'm going to focus it. To focus the specific object in Blender, press delete key in the number pair or the period key in the number pair. Okay, now you can see the object is focused on the camera. Okay, okay, go to the edit mode of the cube by pressing tab key. Okay, you can select the vertex, edge and face by pressing this 3 key in the toolbar. You can also select all the 3 things by holding the shift key, and if you enable this you can select any type of the component of the object, like edges. Also you can select vertex and also face. Okay, I want only the face. Okay, how to see the normal of this face? Okay, you can see the normal of this face by enabling the normals checkbox. Okay, yes, I'm going to enable the face normal. Okay, you can see a line is coming out of the face. Okay, this is the normal of the face. Where, what is the use of the normal? The normal is used for telling in which direction the face is facing. That's it, that's the only use of the normal. The normals is used for calculating, is mainly used for calculating light and calculating the occlusion culling, and also it is used for calculating the collision detection in game. Okay, without normals you cannot calculate the collision, okay, of the object. Okay, normals is very important. There are two type of normals, namely face normal and vertex normal. You can see the vertex normal by enabling the vertex. Okay, you can see a normal is coming out of the vertex, and also you can increase the size of the normal by increasing the size. Okay, now let us do a test. Okay, I'm going to change the normal direction of this face. Okay, to change the normal direction, press Control F. Okay, you can see flip normal. I'm going to flip it out. Now you can see the normal is flipped. Okay, let us see what happened when you flip the normal. Okay, I'm going to change the color. I'm going to apply a material for this. I'm going to apply create new, and I'm going to change the diffuse color of that object. Okay, something like this. Okay, let us get into the game mode of the Blender. I am going to press P key in the keyboard. Now you can see the faces of that of the cube is disappeared. You cannot see the face. Okay, let us rotate the camera and go inside the cube, and now we will press P. Now you can see the face of the cube. Okay, this is because we have changed the direction of the face. You can change again the direction of the normal by selecting the face and press Control F and flip normals. Okay, now let us see the face in the game mode of the Blender. Now you can see the entire faces of the Blender. Okay, so please be very careful in the normals of the object. Okay. Next, how to do extrude in Blender. To do extrude in Blender, just select the face and press E key. Okay, when you press the E key, the face will be oriented, that is constrained along the normal of the face. Okay, and also you can extrude the vertex also the same. Select the vertex and press E key. Okay, you don't want it. And also you can also extrude the edges by selecting the edges and press E key. Okay. Next, I'll teach you how to apply the modifier for this object. Okay, you can apply the modifier for this object by selecting the modifier panel and click Add Modifier. You can find n number of modifiers in the modifier menu. Okay, you can select a lot of modifiers, and you just go through it, and you can change the option of it. Okay, I added a bevel modifier for it. Okay, that's it. Okay guys, that's it guys. This is the basics for the Blender. I will go in depth of the Blender in modeling tutorials of the assets. Okay guys, see you, bye.